नमस्ते, हमेशा खुश रहो बिटिया। माय नेम इज मनीषा सिंह। टुडे आई एम टीचिंग यू खोआ बेस्ड स्वीट्स। फर्स्ट स्वीट इज पेड़ा। पेड़ा इज अ स्वीट प्रिपेयर्ड फ्रॉम पिंडी वैरायटी ऑफ खोआ बाय द एडिशन ऑफ शुगर। सिंस पेड़ा कंटेन्स शुगर एंड लोअर मॉइस्चर कंटेंट, इट हैज अ बेटर कीपिंग क्वालिटी देन खोआ। ओके, पेड़ा हैव रिलीजियस इंपॉर्टेंस एज दे आर ऑफर्ड एज प्रसाद ड्यूरिंग वर्शिप of God in the temples. Peda is also offered to guests at the time of ceremonial celebrations like marriages, etc. Some region specific varieties are popular in different regions of country. For example, Doodh Peda is a common variety and is popular all over India. Peda is characterized as a circular, slightly flattened ball with low moisture content and white to creamy white in color and smooth texture. Basically, we require khoa, and then that khoa is heated to 60 degrees Celsius in a steam jacketed pan. Otherwise, in the normal pan, it will scorched. Then, addition of sugar flavor and mixed in a planetary mixture, transformed to the cold room, transfer to the cold room. Temperature is reduced to the 5 degrees Celsius and transferred to the peda shaping machine and then packaged. It is a industrial process of peda preparation from khoa. Then the another method of preparation of doodh peda is traditional method is about 5 liters of buffalo milk is taken in a pan, open pan, and heated on a brisk non-smoky fire. When the milk reaches a rubbery stage, about 400 to 450 grams sugar is added and stirring and scraping continued until a pasty consistency is obtained. During the last stages of heating, the paste is worked up into a smooth mass. The heating is then stopped and the paste is spread on the walls of the pan for cooling. Then the product is shaped into the either flattened circular balls or rectangular shapes. Then preparation of peda from khoa. Pindi khoa is broken into bits and heated to 90 degrees Celsius. Powdered sugar at the rate 30% on the basis of khoa is added and heating is continued with rigorous working to obtain a smooth pasty consistency. Then the product is cooled and shaped on molds. Then quality of the peda. Chemical quality of peda depends upon the type and quality of the milk, quality of khoa which is used, and the amount of sugar added, method of production, and optional ingredients and flavors are added, and storage condition. The shelf life of the peda can keep well for 5 to 7 days at the room temperature. Peda is packaged in multi-layer transparent laminate pouches under modified atmospheric packages of nitrogen and carbon dioxide, had a shelf life of 15 days at room temperature and 30 days at the 20 degrees Celsius. Next product is Barfi. Barfi is one of the most common product of khoa based indigenous sweets, and it is white to light cream in color with firm body and smooth texture with very fine grains. Sugar is added in different proportions and other ingredients incorporated according to the demand of the consumers. Several varieties of barfi are sold in the market, that is plain, nut, that is kaju pista, chocolate, coconut, and rava barfi. A lot of variation is observed in the chemical composition, sensory, and rheological characteristics in market samples of barfi. The cause of large variation in market samples is due to the non-existence of legal standards. Then there are various varieties of barfis available in the market. These are the mawa barfi, layered barfi, fruit barfi, nut barfi, chocolate barfi, cashew barfi, rava barfi. And then the procedure is buffalo milk is subjected to filtration or clarification and then standardization. For standardization, the milk should contain 6% fat and 9% of SNF, boiling in a kettle with stirring and scraping. And then attainment of semi-solid consistency, then stop heating, and then addition of the powdered sugar, kneading with the wooden ladle till desirable flow characteristics are attained, then pouring in trays, then setting for 4 hours overnight at room temperature, and cut into the desirable shapes and piece sizes, then packaging and storage at the room temperature. This is the preparation of barfi from the milk. Then shelf life of barfi is low moisture content and the presence of sugar keeps barfi well for fairly long periods, and the shelf life of barfi packet in parchment paper is 15 days at 30 degree Celsius and 50 days at 5 degree Celsius. Then the extension of shelf life of burfi is by lowering the moisture content in burfi, that is burfi samples with very low moisture could be stored at for 6 months. However, such lower moisture content renders burfi hard, dry, chewy and unacceptable for the consumers. Then addition of antioxidants, burfi samples treated with propyl gallate and dodecyl gallate and stored at 25 degrees Celsius well for 12 months. Then packaging in tins, burfi packed in tins and stored at 30 degrees Celsius plus minus 10 degrees Celsius was good for 150 days. Next is hot filling. Filling burfi into tins while hot was suggested to prevent the growth of molds and off flavor development during storage for a period of 1 year. Next is use of antifungal agents, that is incorporation of 0.15 sorbic% sorbic acid in burfi and packaging in polyethylene pouches enhance the shelf life of burfi up to 90 days. Next type of product is Kalakand. Kalakand is a milk sweet basically prepared from danedar variety of khoa. Kalakand is characterized by large sized hard grains with less cohesive body. The chemical composition of Kalakand is more or less similar to the burfi, but there are large differences in the sensory and rheological properties of two sweets. Contrary to burfi, Kalakand has more distinct cooked flavor and brown color. The body of Kalakand is greasier and grainy texture. The grains are hard and of large size. Good quality Kalakand is normally prepared in one step from buffalo milk. However, it can be also be prepared from khoa. The formally set product is cut into required shape and sizes, and when making Kalakand from khoa, danedar variety is used. Then method of production is buffalo milk is preferred for Kalakand manufacture because it has high fat content, and slightly sour milk can be used for its preparation. Buffalo milk standardized to 6% fat and 9% SNF, taken in a pan and dissolved and boiled. At the appearance of first boil, 0.05% citric acid is added, dissolved in the small quantity of water is added to the milk, and there is no need to add citric acid in case of slightly acidic milk. The milk is boiled with continuous stirring and scraping at pat formation stage. Sugar at the rate 30% on expected yield of khoa or alternatively 7.5% on the basis of milk is added and stirring is continued. When desirable textural and body characteristics are achieved, mixture is removed from fire and poured in a tray, smeared with a thin layer of ghee for setting. The Kalakand is cut into desirable shapes or alternatively served as such without any definite shape. Next type of milk product is milk cake. Milk cake is a khoa based sweet prepared from either buffalo milk or from danedar variety of khoa. Milk cake differs from Kalakand for its higher content of sugar, lower moisture content and slightly more sticky and chewy grains. Milk cake has two distinct layers, that is central dark brown color, colored caramelized center covered by the light colored product on the entire surface. Whereas Kalakand is characterized by uniform whitish to light brown color throughout the mass. The method of production is, first of all, we need to take a milk in a boiled in an open pan. When milk comes to first boil, 0.05% citric acid on milk basis is added as 1% solution. After addition of citric acid solution, small tiny granules tend to appear in the milk. Heating is continued further with rigorous stirring. When the mass shows signs of leaving the surface of pan, sugar at the rate 50% of expected khoa yield, 12.5% on the basis of milk is added, and the mix is heated with rigorous stirring. Controlled heating is required at this stage to obtain better quality product. When the product shows signs of dry appearance, the mix is poured in deep metal molds while hot. The milk cake is allowed to cool slowly at room temperature so that the central portion of the pat turns brown and caramelized flavor develops due to the residual heat. After cooling, the product is cut into the desirable sizes. At times, the vessel containing the hot mass is placed in a container with water so that the surface of the milk cake cools fast, giving whitish appearance outside and brown coloration in the central core. Then packaging of milk cake is the pieces of milk cake are generally packaged in a vegetable parchment lined paper board boxes and individual pieces are packed in the LDPE pouches. Then the shelf life, since milk cake contains higher amount of sugar and lower moisture content, it has longer shelf life than the Kalakand and milk cake will have 15 to 20 days shelf life at room temperature. Next type of food product is gulab jamun. Gulab jamun is also a khoa based sweet popular all over the India. The variety of khoa having 40 to 45% moisture is preferred for gulab jamun preparation. Manufacture of gulab jamun is largely in the hands of halwais who adopt small scale batch method, and there are large variation in the sensory quality of gulab jamun. The most liked product should have brown color, smooth and spherical shape, soft and slightly spongy body, free from both lumps and central hard core, uniform granular texture with cooked flavor and free from doughy feel. And the sweet should be fully succulent with sugar syrup with optimum sweetness. BIS specifications of gulab jamun is, the gulab jamun shall be prepared from khoa, skim milk powder, ghee, cream, butter or other milk solids. It may contain maida, citric acid and baking powder, and it shall be free from dirt and other foreign matter as well as the insects and the mold growth. It should be as far as possible manufactured and packed under hygienic conditions, and the proportion of free syrup in gulab jamun shall not exceed 60% of the declared net mass. Then the method of preparation is, dhap variety of khoa, maida and baking powder are blended to form homogeneous and smooth dough. Then small amount of moisture can be added in the case of hard dough, and if it does not roll into the smooth balls, the mix should be prepared fresh every time, and the balls are then deep fried, fat fried in at 140 degrees Celsius to the golden brown color and transferred into the 60% sugar syrup maintained at 60 degrees Celsius, and it takes about 2 hours for the balls to completely absorb the sugar syrup. The yield of gulab jamun is expressed in terms of train weight. In general, 1 liter buffalo milk is expected to give 1 kg gulab jamun. Then shelf life. The shelf life of the gulab jamun at ambient temperature in sugar syrup is 5 to 7 days, which can be extended to 3 weeks by hot filling in polystyrene tubs and adding 0.1% of potassium sorbate as a preservative. Product is filled hot in previously sterilized metal cans after running through a steam chest for 7 to 8 minutes and sealed. This process is expected to give a shelf life of 6 months at room temperature. Hope you all are satisfied with this session. This session is powered by Digital Version 2.0 Jyoti Vidyapeeth Women's University, Jaipur. If you have any query, please mention it in a comment box. I will resolve them whenever we have a live session. Thank you so much for watching this video.